Meet the Press with Hugh Riminton.
Hello, welcome to Meet the Press. Systemic corruption, lies, cover-ups. Are churches and institutions or the Labor Party as allegations fly? The opposition has made it clear the last parliamentary sitting week of the year will be used to target the Prime Minister.
New evidence has emerged. Documentary evidence.
Well, that new evidence amounts to three separate statements to police from self-confessed fraudster Ralph Bluett and some claims from a former Prime Ministerial work colleague about a fax Julia Gillard might never have seen to do with a mortgage she previously claimed to know nothing about on a house her former boyfriend was living in.
There is no doubt Ms Gillard knew of the mortgage from Slater and Gordon in March of 1993.
Against that, the former boyfriend Bruce Wilson has broken his silence today to assert Julia Gillard knew absolutely categorically nothing about the union fraud. Not that that satisfies the opposition.
There'll be questions about where the hundreds of thousands of dollars went out of this slush fund and hasn't been recovered. There's questions about her knowledge, her involvement, and that will be supported by documents.
This whole campaign of smear actually boils down to absolutely nothing.
A simple denial is not enough. An explanation is necessary.
Here we are, 20 years, acres of newsprint. If anybody's got an allegation of wrongdoing by me of any substance, please feel free to put it.
Well, tomorrow also marks the deadline for the churches, states and victims groups to have their say on the shape of the new Royal Commission into sex abuse in our institutions, potentially the largest inquiry in Australian history.
Many people want to tell their story. A lot of people have held this within inside themselves for many, many years.
WA Premier Colin Barnett fears it will end with the ruin of great institutions. Tony Abbott agrees.
I think these are perfectly legitimate concerns from the Premier.
So will the Royal Commission expose the Catholic Church, for example, to what it has always managed to avoid? Legally enforceable compensation claims running to hundreds of millions of dollars.
It would be far too rash at this stage to try to rule in or out if it might lead to proposals about appropriate compensation.
Wherever you look, there's the law. Attorney General Nicola Roxon is our guest today. And let's not forget the New South Wales ICAC investigation that has gutted what's left of the reputation of at least two former New South Wales ministers.
This afternoon, I've moved for the suspension of Eddie Obeid's membership of the Labor Party.
Well, New South Wales Premier Barry O'Farrell has some things he wants to get off his chest on that subject. He joins us later on. And you can have your say on Twitter, the hashtag MTP10. Plenty ahead. Back in a moment.